morning, everyone. And I'm Dr. Sujit Kumar Sinha, and I'm working as an associate professor at Department of Audiology at the All India Institute of Speech and Hearing, Mysuru. And I hope you all are staying safe at your home in this pandemic era, which is going on right now. Okay. And today I'm going to present a very small tutorial on hearing aids. And this particular device is used for individuals who have a hearing loss. And this particular type of hearing loss cannot be cured through medicine or surgery. First, let us understand, before we understand the hearing aid, let us understand our ear. Our ear can be divided into three parts: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The pinna is the outermost part, which all of us can see. And after that, there is a canal, and then there is a drum, and then there are three small bones which are there in the middle ear, and then there is inner ear. When we look into the two ears, when the sound arrives at the two ears. Then the sound from the outer ear, it goes to the middle ear, and via inner ear and the neurons, it goes to the brain. In the brain, we understand the meaning of the sound which is coming from our surroundings. There are various pathologies or diseases which can affect our ear system. Any pathologies or disease which is affecting our outer ear and middle ear leads to hearing loss, which is called as a conductive hearing loss, whereas any pathologies or disease which is affecting the inner ear will lead to a hearing loss, which is called as a sensory neural hearing loss. Let us look into the treatment options for the conductive hearing loss and the sensory neural hearing loss. The treatment options for conductive hearing loss is a medicine or surgery. The conductive hearing loss can be corrected using medicine and surgery, whereas the sensory neural hearing loss cannot be corrected using medicine or surgery. And this is the type of hearing loss where an individual will require a hearing aid. Let us understand some of the signs and symptoms of hearing loss. The first sign and symptoms of the hearing loss is that the individual is not able to hear the sound properly, or the individual is not able to hear the soft sound. The person also complains of understanding a speech in the presence of noise, or problem in understanding speech in a crowd. That is, if there are four or five people talking together, they won't understand what they are talking. They also have difficulty in understanding the group conversation, and they will ask for frequent repetitions from the other individual. One of the most common sign and symptom of hearing loss is that this individual will increase the volume of television at their homes. How to know whether we require a hearing aid or not if we have a hearing loss? If you have a hearing loss, you must visit a qualified audiologist for a detailed assessment. The audiologist will do a detailed assessment, and then he or she is going to confirm whether you will require a hearing aid or not. The hearing loss can occur in adults as well as it can occur in children also. The difference between the adult and the children is that if the hearing loss occurs in adults, they would have already acquired language, whereas a child wouldn't have acquired language if the child has congenital hearing loss or the child has hearing loss since birth. In that case, when the child has hearing loss since birth, the child will require a detailed assessment of hearing, and then the child will be fitted with a hearing aid. And along with the hearing aid, the child will also require a speech language therapy and listening therapy. Now let us look into what is a hearing aid device. A hearing aid device is basically a personal amplification device. When I say personal amplification device, it is nothing but a device which will amplify the incoming sound. That means to say that it will increase the loudness of the sound. And it basically consists of three components: a microphone, which will pick up the sound which is coming from our surrounding or the environment; and an amplifier which will amplify the sound or increase the loudness of the sound, and a receiver which will deliver the sound to the ear. Now let us look into some of the devices which are commonly available in the market for individuals with hearing loss. This is the first device, which is called as a pocket level hearing aid. And a pocket level hearing aid basically consists of a hearing aid and a receiver which is connected through a small wire which is also called as cord. Now this is a very basic hearing aid wherein a receiver is fitted inside the ear and the main body of the hearing aid is kept inside the pocket of the individual. This is a very basic type of hearing aid. The second type of hearing aid which is available in the market is called as BT hearing aids or behind the ear hearing aids. This type of hearing aid is very small and can be just kept behind the pinna or behind the ear, and a small tube which will go to the ear will carry the sound from the hearing aid to the ear. Another type of hearing aid which is commonly available in the market is called as receiver in the canal hearing aid or receiver in the hearing aid. Now this receiver in the canal hearing aid, basically the receiver part of it is fitted outside the hearing aid, and hence this type of hearing aid becomes too small. The next type of hearing aid which is available in the market is called as in-the-ear hearing aid. In-the-ear hearing aid is much smaller compared to the behind-the-ear hearing aid, and this can be fitted inside the ear itself. As you can see in this picture, this some part of the hearing aid will be visible from outside. Next type of hearing aid which is available in the market is called as CIC hearing aid or completely in-canal hearing aid. Completely in-canal hearing aid is much smaller compared to in-the-ear hearing aid, and it is fitted inside the canal of the individual. Now in this picture you can see that only a very small portion of the hearing aid which is visible from outside. The next type of hearing aid which is available in the market is called as invisible in the canal hearing aid, and this is much smaller compared to CIC hearing aid, and this will be fitted completely inside the canal and this is not visible from outside. Now talking about the technologies which are available in the hearing aid, there are two types of technologies which are available in the hearing aid. One is an analog hearing aid and second is a digital hearing aid. The benefit of digital hearing aid is that this gives a much clearer speech compared to the basic analog hearing aids. Now in the analog hearing aid, these are available in pocket level hearing aid, BT hearing aid, ITC hearing aids and the IT hearing aids. Whereas the digital hearing aids are available in the form of BT hearing aids, CIC hearing aid, ITC hearing aids and IIC hearing aids. Now, a general question which is being asked by all the patients is that whether I require one hearing aid or I require two hearing aids. Generally, it is recommended that we have a balanced hearing because of 2 ears. So, fitting with binaural devices or fitting 2 ears will always give a balanced hearing to the individual. In the case of child or if the child has a congenital hearing loss, binaural hearing aid fitting is must. That means say that always 2 hearing aids will be provided in the case of children. In the adults also it is recommended that people should use 2 hearing aids rather than 1 hearing aid. Another question which comes to the mind of the client is that what is the cost of a hearing aid? The cost of hearing aid somewhere varies between 2000 rupees up to 3 lakhs rupees. Basically this cost depends upon the technologies and the facilities which are available in the hearing aid. Thank you.